Have you ever thought about where we would be without the World Wide Web? It's hard, isn't it? Well, its creators are celebrating the web's 20-year anniversary by relaunching the first website ever created. This not-so-glamorous-looking site is for the European Organization for Nuclear Research. It was created by CERN. It also operates the world's largest particle physics lab. The site was meant to teach people about the World Wide Web project back in 1992. The web actually dates back to 1989 thanks to CERN physicist Tim Berners-Lee. He created it to provide a networked system that allowed CERN physicists to read and publish documents and to create links between and within them. But that initial vision was clearly changed to what we now think of as the internet. In 1993, CERN made the World Wide Web technology available to the public for free. Yes, the internet was free for some time after its birth. One of the collaborators on the project says making the technology free to the rest of the world wasn't exactly a no-brainer. What we had was not a patentable, slick app. The arguments were complex, the models untried, and it was not clear what would happen to the World Wide Web in either case. That phrase, not patentable, also may be a thing of the past, as restrictions around digital rights management or limits on what people can do with content like music or movies continue to rise. But while the web may not be the free knowledge collection Berners-Lee had hoped for, a writer for CNET explains some of CERN's initial vision is still showing up on today's web. The barriers for building websites and services are generally very low. That's what's made it possible for countless businesses to set up shop on the internet, building a remarkably connected global network of information. A remarkably connected global network of information. Sounds an awful lot like Berners-Lee's initial vision of CERN physicists having access to each other's work. That being said, his vision formed long before anyone even thought of those things like Harlem Shake or cat videos. For Newsy, I'm Carissa Lathan.